Work.
I play Lindy Taylor. It's a lot of fun, you know. She's kind of the beauty of the story, but not the stereotypical beauty that I think everyone thinks of. She's doing her own thing, you know, and she is a strong and independent individual.
Did I ever congratulate you on Treasurer? I probably never apologized for my Aholian election behavior either.
Well, 2 weeks ago was the first and last time he spoke to me in 3 years, so no.
He is obsessed with his own vanity. And can't see the real beauty of life. So, yeah, he's not a very nice guy.
Lindy's relationship with the Beast starts off quite involuntarily, and they kind of grow to love each other. I'm not sure if I actually kissed him in his Beast state. I actually, still to this day, have not seen him in his Beast costume because they're saving it as a surprise for me, so the reaction is genuine. So, I still don't know what to expect.
What's with her?
Pity Mac.
Because you got Flesh Eater at 4 o'clock.
And here we go.
Kendra sort of takes Kyle, who's Alex, the Beast lead character, sort of on his journey. She could be a witch type, but I think everything that she does is for the good and for his good. She's a very strong character. I mean, the way she walks and talks and looks at people, it's all sort of it's by choice, and, it's eerie.
It's like a modern Beauty and the Beast. It's got a tale of love and a tale of coming to reason with who you are as a person. And, you know, this story is different to Beauty and the Beast because it's all in the Beast's side. You kind of go on this journey with Kyle from beginning to end, and kind of see how his arc changes and how he changes as a person to, as I said at the beginning, not seeing the beauty of life to seeing things that, you know, some people like you and me wouldn't be able to see or, you know, feel or, you know, a lot of people are cut off from emotion, and this guy is completely cut off from everything in the world, and it's a beautiful story.
I think there's a great message in this film, you know, beauty isn't always as it seems to the eye. There's so much more, and I think that we're really putting that out there in this movie. I'm having a great time. We're having so much fun. I love Mary-Kate. She's so sweet. We've been having a really good time, you know. We're just starting off right now, but it's fun. We're creating all these characters that are very defined, so it's neat to be able to play like that with people who really like doing what they're doing. Vanessa is just the nicest, and she's funny and smart and a great actress. She's amazing to watch. And Alex has been, he's such a strong actor. He's got a very big heart, and he's very passionate about what he does, and it's so nice to see.
There's a lot of films that say, oh, we've become a family, and I did a lot of pre-production on this film, and it's really become such a, like, nice set to be on, and everyone is so friendly. It's a very young vibe. And yeah, we were all having a lot of fun. How many 19-year-olds can say that they're in Montreal making a movie with beautiful women? It's the first time in Montreal, and it's a beautiful city, man. Beautiful women. It's like got a combination of Europe and New York together. It's awesome.
I love it. It's charming. That's the perfect word, charming. Cobblestone streets and, I don't know, it's charming and weird. You know, there's like a Christmas shop next to a church, next to a cupcake store, and a, you know, I don't know, it's weird, but it's awesome. I love it in Montreal so much. I've fallen in love with this place. I don't want to leave. I've been watching fireworks, and there's a lot of concerts, and it's just a great atmosphere. I don't know if there's a better place to work than here in Montreal.
Are you doing any singing in this film?
No singing. No singing in this movie. Mock singing, just kind of a fun blurt out, but nothing planned or staged out.